Today we'll take a look at the Surface Deployment Accelerator, which helps simplify surface image creation and deployment. In the next few minutes, I will show you how it provides an easy way to create the best reference image for Surface, how you can use this to configure your custom image and kick off an automated deployment. First, I download and install Surface Deployment Accelerator onto a Windows server. This has to be Windows Server 2012 R2 or higher. SDA comes as a single MSI package that you can download from the Microsoft Download Center by using the link below and then install it on a Windows server. Since I have already downloaded the Surface Deployment Accelerator MSI file, I start the installation of it. I accept the license agreement, press install, and it quickly installs Surface Deployment Accelerator on my device. The next step is to start the actual configuration of SDA. I press the Windows button, and you will see on the start screen there is now a Surface Deployment Accelerator tile. I hit OK, and this is where we start the Surface Deployment Accelerator wizard. The very first thing you will see is the welcome experience. On the welcome screen, you can see the summary of what the accelerator does. When you press Next, that's where we perform system verification. Within system verification, we first check to make sure that PowerShell execution policy is set to bypass, as well as making sure that you have the Windows Assessment Deployment Kit and Microsoft Deployment Toolkit installed. But don't worry, if you haven't installed already, SDA will grab the latest files from the internet and install that for you as well. When you press Next, that's where you can choose which operating system you want to install. In my case, since I want to install on a Surface Pro 4, I will choose Windows 10. I press this checkmark to enable Windows 10 support, and you will see that the below area is now active and I can choose what I want to do with it. So the first thing you want to do is creating a deployment share. So I press Browse and choose the location where I want to store my deployment share. Let's create a new folder under System Drive and call it Mechanics. Hit OK. And now I'm going to choose a share name. So let's use again Mechanics. And I will also add a dollar sign. All what that means is, when you choose a dollar sign, it's hidden from the network. In some cases, you will want to import the boot media directly onto the local Windows deployment service. This is the right thing to do in my case, so I choose the checkbox. And lastly, I need to define where the Windows 10 source files are. So that's, for example, your ISO file from Windows 10. I press Browse, and since I already mounted the ISO, I just simply click on my E drive, press OK, and hit Next. Within the experience configuration, you can choose which Surface applications and which Surface you want to support with SDA. As I mentioned before, since I have chosen to deploy on a Surface Pro 4 Windows 10, I'm going to select now Surface Pro 4, and I'm going to keep the Surface app as well as the Surface Asset Tech CLI utility present. The cool thing about SDA is, if you don't have internet connection, that's no problem. All you need to make sure is that the drivers and firmware is already loaded on the server, so you can make use of that. So in the case of offline provisioning, you press copy from a local directory and you choose where those files are. So in my case, since I want to make sure that I have the latest and greatest, and since I have internet connection, I choose to download from the internet. Now I press Next. And within the summary page, it will outline all the configuration you have chosen within the wizard. I press Finish. And now Surface Deployment Accelerator is running its own task sequence to configure itself on your Windows server. Once the SDA configuration is completed, I can now open the Deployment Workbench from Microsoft Deployment Toolkit and verify what happened in the background. You will notice that the newly created Mechanics deployment share shows up here. And for example, under operating system, you can see now Windows 10. And within the task sequence, I now have two task sequences pre-configured for me. Option one is for IT professionals that want to start the deployment immediately, while option two can be used when you want to have a baseline image and then you want to build on top of it. That's useful for organizations that want to add additional steps. For example, you might want to add your organization wallpaper or want to make sure that all the Windows updates are present. Now let's move over to the Surface Pro 4 and begin the actual deployment. What you want to have ready for that is either the Surface Ethernet adapter or a Surface dock attached to the device. Once attached, you now want to power on the device. But remember, in order to enable network boot, you want to press power and volume down at the same time. This will enable the alternate boot order, and since the Surface Ethernet adapter is already attached, it will detect it and boot from network. It will first try to find a PXE server, and once that's done, you want to press Enter in order to get into the Windows deployment service. At that point, it will detect the boot media which we previously imported and then begin the injection of that boot media. The next thing you see is the Windows logo from the boot media, and now you're within the WinPE environment. Depending on your server configuration, you might be required to enter your administrator credentials. Now within this menu, you can now choose which task sequence you want to pick. Those are the same task sequences I showed you earlier when I was in the deployment workbench. In my case, because I want to start immediately deploying on a Surface Pro 4 Windows 10, I go for option 1. So that's a new Surface Deployment Accelerator. You can learn more about Surface Management and Engineering on Microsoft Mechanics. Thank you for watching.